A family is heartbroken tonight and seeking justice after a double shooting. Good evening. I'm Todd McDermott.
And I'm Tiffany Kenny. Thank you for joining us. Family members spoke only with WPBF 25 News after they say the two men were lured out of their home and shot. Ari Height is live at St. Mary's Medical Center with the latest. Ari?
Yeah, and I just heard from the family members of one of the victims. I've got good news. They spent hours in surgery today, but both victims are expected to be okay in the long run. Meanwhile, police tonight are still searching for their shooter.
My heart is broke. I'm just in shock.
Investigators placed numbered placards on the ground, each one indicating a shell casing from a fired bullet. This is the 5,000 block of Pat Place in West Palm Beach, where two people were shot, including this man, Spencer Weathersbee. His family doesn't know who shot him or why.
I just know I got a call at work that my son had been shot in the head. I'm just so tired of these killings and shootings, and I'm just tired of it. You know, he's only 20 years old.
Family members say it happened around 5 o'clock. Spencer was in his home with a friend. Police have not yet released that friend's identity. They got a phone call, and the two men went outside.
And when they went outside, my niece just heard shots, and she looked out the window and saw my nephew laying down. And she opened the door, and he was saying, "Help me, help me."
The two men were able to drive themselves to St. Mary's Medical Center. Their vehicle has also now become part of the crime scene. Families are now praying for their loved ones, praying for their survival.
I'm telling you guys, stop the shooting. Stop it. Stop it. It don't make any sense. He would always help and want to please everybody, but I was like, you can't please everybody. You know, he just was always giving. Whoever done this, turn yourself in right now. Turn yourself in. You don't have to do this. Why are people shooting and killing people? Why?
That's a question right now police have not been able to answer at this point. They've not talked about a motive at all, nor have they mentioned anything about a suspect. Tiffany?
And Ari, this is not the first time that this family has dealt with a heartbreaking loss.
No, it certainly is not. It was back in 2005, actually, December of 2005. A man by the name of Courtney Lewis was working for the city of West Palm Beach when he was shot and killed in Coleman Park. Courtney Lewis is Spencer Weathersbee's cousin. So like you said, not the first time they've been touched by violent crime. That crime remains unsolved even now, almost 7 years later. Family members, as you say, as you heard, hoping this time around the shooter turns himself in. We're live tonight at St. Mary's Medical Center. Ari Height, WPBF 25.